please welcome my next guest in studio, Quincy Health Commissioner Drew Scheele, has stopped on by in his capacity as the new chairman of the Quincy Board of License Commissioners to update us on yesterday's Board of License Commissioners meeting. But maybe we can talk about some health stuff too, Drew.
Sure, whatever you want to do, Joe.
While you're here. Good morning.
Good to be here.
Yeah, great to have
you. Thanks for the invite.
Pleasure.
We're going to become even closer than we are now. Huh?
As I said on the phone yesterday, when you assumed the chairmanship of the Board of License Commissioners, I bet you didn't know that the job came with having to talk to me.
As the vice chair, I have stepped in for Joe a couple of times, so I knew it was on the horizon that I'd spend a lot more time here.
Well, we appreciate it.
I'll be challenging Ruthie Jones to the time spent here.
That's right. Oh, that's an interesting challenge.
Yeah,
okay,
she's good here. She
start a tally.
A lot of time here.
So, actually, first of all, how do you feel being chairman of the board now?
It's fine.
Yeah?
I'm okay with it.
You're okay with it?
Yeah.
How long have you been on the board, actually?
I've been on the board since 2002, July of 2002. Is that
okay?
What it was? No. 2000.
So more than 10 years.
Yeah. 2003, January of 2003, I think.
All right.
Something like that.
13 years.
Yeah, 13, 14 years.
Vice chair that whole time? Or?
Chief Tom Gorman was vice chair when I first came on.
Okay.
And Chief Gorman he's just fantastic.
Mm-hmm.
Talk about a memory for the history of the city of Quincy.
Just like Joe Shea.
Yeah. He and Joe could rival Joe.
Yes.
Yeah, because he was a little older than Joe, so
yep.
He could go further back than Joe.
Put the two of them together
Chief Gorman was the vice chair for probably 3 years, 4 years, and then I became the vice chair.
All right.
So okay. About 10 years I've been the vice chair.
Okay. Who will be the new vice chair?
The new vice chair was elected also yesterday at the beginning of the meeting, and it is the Director of Inspectional Services, Jay Duca.
Oh, okay.
Who I have a great amount of respect for. Jay is just a class guy.
Great. And, of course, Nicole Crispo.
She is the new city clerk.
Yep.
A lot of respect for Nicole. She's so hardworking. She's going to work great with the board. And, you know, we have Chief Paul Keenan and Chief Joe Barron, and they do their work on the board. We get the business done, and I hope to continue that role that we serve and make sure everyone gets their due process when they cross the line, and hopefully we'll be successful in what we do.
Yeah,
so that's my goal as the chairman.
Okay. You've got a brand new space to do it in, and that first floor meeting room at City Hall.
Very, very nice to be there.
Yeah. Those great big windows.
It is.
Look right out on what will soon be the Walk of Names.
Yeah. It's a beautiful, the building just came out absolutely spectacular.
Yep.
Can't say enough about it. Just tremendous.
It's
special being in there.
Because we know what it was before.
Exactly.
And then to see it now, the transformation truly is night and day. It is quite amazing to see. And it was nice over the winter not to have to worry about water pouring down
exactly.
over your
exactly.
head. And now the basement's getting used, too.
Yes.
That I never foresaw in my lifetime. So
it's the space is just incredible.
Yeah.
It really, really is.
Let's talk about yesterday's meeting, if we can.
Okay, so the licensing board met April 26th in the first floor, and we had six items on the agenda. One of the items actually was continued until May 10th at the request of Attorney Iaeda, and that was the common vicular license at 247 Atlantic Street.
Mm-hmm.
That's the old Richards Market. So
oh.
They had a coffee break was in there, and they've left. And these people are going to be going in there, and we're having a couple of issues that we're just still trying to iron out. So we continued that until May 10th.
Okay.
And then the next hearing that we had was a continuation of a hearing on 665 Quincy Shore Drive, Mr. Armin Suhlman. He owns the gas station there, and he has a Motor 2 and a garage repair license already, and he wants to extend the number of cars that he has. He currently has a 12-car license, and he wants 25 cars.
Oh, okay.
So the board, after much discussion, and we had one individual come up and speak in favor of Mr. Iman, saying he was a good neighbor. He lives right next door to the place, and he hasn't had any issues. myself and Director Duca went down and looked at the property, and after discussion of the board, we decided that 20 cars would be appropriate. He can have 10 for sale and 10 for repair. And, you know, we put numbers on all of these gas stations where they do any type of Motor 2 use also. And because gas stations are in the repair business, and we said this at the meeting yesterday, you could have 20 cars on there, but you go by on a busy Wednesday, you could see 25 or 26 cars on that lot. He may have, you know, 5 or 6 cars that are being repaired that day. He may have 8 or 10 cars being repaired that day. Someone might not come and pick up a car.
True.
He could end up the day with 22 cars on there.
Okay.
You know what? As long as the cars are being turned over and he's not just storing them there.
Okay.
That's what we look at when we put a number on these. You know, we want them to keep as close to 20 as possible. And if we go down there and we start to see 30 on a regular basis, then we're going to bring them in.
Okay.
And that goes for any of these car dealerships that we have out there that are Motor 2s.
Yeah. So you're trying to work with them, be flexible, right?
Oh, absolutely. Yeah. And again, these people are in the business to repair cars.
Sure.
You try to schedule appointments. Some people don't schedule appointments. They show
up. That's true. Yeah. Or, so, I mean, you get a flat tire on the way to work, you got to pull in.
You got to pull in. Yeah. So we put the number there, but I don't want residents to think that, well, he had 21 cars there. That's a violation.
Okay. All right.
So So that's why that's
– Every case is different.
Here's my chairmanship coming
that's,
in.
That's right. Very good, Drew.
There you go.
Let me get you your gavel.
So, yeah. So the other – we had three charities on today. All great charities. We had Granite Telecommunications came in for a one-day special use permit for their annual Granite Day on Newport Ave, Mr. George Meegan. And this is the 13th year that they've done it.
Wow. Okay.
And they've raised over $4 million, I believe, for Dana-Farber since they've been doing this.
Amazing.
So you look at something like that, 13th annual, Dana-Farber, $4 million. That's just great.
It's stunning, so, yeah. When is that?
That is on June 4th.
Okay, and I know that has grown by leaps and bounds over the years. Really, it's become a family event now.
You're going to kill me because I never got back to the office to grab my sheet today.
Oh, okay.
And I'm not going to have the date for the 6th annual Pinewood or the Feel the Beat Road Race.
Okay. I'm not going to kill you, but Troop 6 is.
Troop 6 is going to kill me, I know. Right. This is my first time, I get cut a little slack, right?
Yes, we'll be flexible.
The other two charities that we had the request of Friends of Troop 6 in Howe's Neck for the one-day special use permit for their 6th annual Pinewood Derby. And this is for the adults.
Okay.
And they came before us for a one-day wine and malt license.
Okay.
And I'm actually going to enter this year. I have an application.
Really?
And it's $25, and they'll give you the little kit that you have to make your Pinewood Derby car.
Yeah.
I think they had about 50 contestants last year.
Pretty good.
Chief Keenan said he'd pitch in a dollar to help me pay for my kit to see if I can do it. So if I get 4 other members of the board to, then it'll only cost me $16.
Okay.
So that
that'll be fun. By the way,
that's at the Howe's Neck Congregational Church too.
Okay, and I bet you it's on. If it's not on the Howe's Neck Community Council website,
it
it's on the church website
for
sure. Yeah,
exactly.
Okay,
and then third charity was the 2nd annual request for the Claire Joni Brennan Foundation for a special use permit for the annual Feel the Beat Road Race. Mm. And last year they had about 60 people sign up that actually pre-registered. And they ended up with over 200 people who showed up for the race. Police had no issues with it. It went fantastic. I believe it starts up at Pageant Field and ends up there.
Oh, the typical route around Forestburg and back. Okay.
Exactly.
Nice.
5K route.
Yep.
And that's 8 a.m. to 1 p.m. And again,
it's at some point this spring.
It's coming up soon.
Okay.
And I apologize for that. So that's, I'll have to make sure I.
Well, you know, for your
you
for your first report.
Round I one.
Mean, yeah.
Round one's a big swing and a miss.
Joe had a lot of experience with
this.
So we'll cut you some slack.
So, and we also, Deputy Chief Joe Jackson sat in for Chief Joe Barron yesterday at the meeting.
Very good.
And that's all that we had at the Quincy Licensing Board of Commissioners yesterday. It was a fun day.
For your first report as chairman.
Yes.
And when it, now, Joe would always tell me, and the next meeting is
and
scheduled.
And the next meeting is May 10th.
Okay. Very good.
So we'll have a full agenda, I assume, on May 10th.
I'm sure, yeah. One issue I did want to ask you about, I think that the Clash of the Ash has elected to appeal.
The Clash of the Ash has appealed and has been the custom with the city of Quincy. When people are appealing, we afford them that right to stay open.
Right.
So they'll still be open until 1 a.m.
Okay.
While the appeal process goes through. And that's something that, you know, I'm going to continue to. I mean, everyone's has due process, and mm-hmm. you don't want to punish someone if they're due process isn't given. So
there's a process to go through,
there's
sure.
Process, yeah, and Rome wasn't built in a day.
That's right.
But yeah, they're on appeal, and we'll just wait to see what happens at the ABCC.
Okay, very good. For folks who don't know, the board voted unanimously to revoke that license. That was a pretty harsh step. Yeah,
it was their third violation.
Right.
So we think it was warranted.
Okay, very good. Drew, when the with the downtown developments, as new restaurants and establishments come on board, do they have to come before the licensing board?
All of the new establishments have to come before the board if they're going to do any type of common vicular license, which would be serving food on premise or to go, and if they're doing any type of liquor. So we do have liquor licenses available specifically designed for the downtown area.
Right.
Must always remain in the downtown area.
Gotcha.
They can never be moved out of the parameters that have been set up, and I believe currently they are from School Street to Granite Street, parking way over to, I think it's only the, is it Dennis? What's the
Dennis Ryan Parkway?
Is that the where the courthouse is?
Yes, yeah.
I believe maybe. Might be Washington Street, but I just have to check on that. But I think it might be Dennis Ryan.
Okay. All right.
So
those are designated for the urban renewal district.
For the urban renewal, yes.
Okay.
We've already issued one of those licenses, and we've issued a full alcohol retail
package
license.
Store.
That's,
okay.
Yeah, that's part of the urban renewal.
Okay.
And I believe that was the only one of those that we have. We have one beer and wine that's available, and the rest will be CV liquor. A couple of them are reserved only for hotels.
Oh, okay.
So
for
that.
Bars inside the hotels.
Yeah.
Okay.
So
going to be interesting to watch that project.
It's going to be interesting
unfold.
To watch it grow.
Yeah.
You know, we're moving forward. I'm so excited for it. You see the cranes going up.
Yep.
West of Chestnut is nearly complete.
First building is ready to go, yeah.
Yeah, you look at the Galvin site that's being all renovated, and that's on the move.
Mm-hmm.
And then the two big projects, Central is going up right now, and so
things are changing.
Yes.
Yeah, things are changing for sure.
So one of the things I can talk about, too, since we're here,
yep.
is I went before the city council on Monday night.
Yes, you did.
To talk about rats.
Yes, let's change your hat from chairman of the Board of Commissioners to health commissioner.
Here. So obviously after the show was aired and there was a lot of news and everything else, my phones have spiked a little. I'm actually, when I leave here, I have four places that I'm going to right from here.
Rat reports.
To go out
yeah.
and
did you bring your rubber gloves with you?
I have my rubber gloves, okay. Yep. I usually walk around with a 7-iron just in case. You never know.
Okay.
But, you know, when we talk about ways we can prevent this from happening,
yeah.
you know, you really have to eliminate their food source, their water source, and their harborage. The harborage can be anywhere. They love the big trees and bushes. They love
trees.
They'll burrow under the ground
oh.
and they'll follow the root system of the trees, and that will act as their roof.
Oh,
so they'll follow that root all the way out. That's why they love trees and bushes with a lot of roots. They'll have a lot of different holes coming up burrows.
Oh. Okay,
so. You have to look for those. They also love compost piles if they're not maintained.
Mm.
That's a food source for them.
Okay.
They also, if you have any type of bird feeders in your yard, water feeders, any type of water source, they only need less than an ounce of water and less than an ounce of food a day to survive.
Wow. Okay.
They multiply quickly every 23 days for their gestation period. 8 to 12 babies. Female can have 4 to 7 litters in a lifetime.
Wow.
They only live 6 to 12 months. So they can really... So you want to eliminate the food sources, the burrows. You want to eliminate any concrete slabs, stone walls, anything that they can burrow under and use as a roof.
Okay.
They really like that. They love sheds that are raised up off the ground about 6 inches or 4 inches.
Uh-oh.
You know how you can buy the sheds and they have them on the stones.
Cinder blocks,
brick,
yeah.
Cinder blocks. Well, that gives them that feeling of confinement.
That's their roof.
So they like going under those places.
Okay. I'm going to check my own now that you mentioned that. Okay.
But, you know, if anyone has any issues, they can call my office, 617-376-1275, and we'll come out and we'll take a look around, and if there's anything we can do, we'll help you out and make sure we get rid of the problem.
Okay. I mean, do you think, I've heard people say, all this construction all over the city is rousting them out of their holes and creating more of a problem?
We had one area that was reported in the downtown area, and it was along Parking Way, the parking lot area.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of bushes right there, the big pine green bushes. So we baited that area there. We actually baited all around the brook on the outside part, that little area where you can, right by the restaurants that used to flow underneath.
Yep.
We baited down there. We had no activity on that particular spot down there, which I thought was unusual. But we baited that whole area. But it's, how do you say that all the construction is creating rats out in Squanum?
Mm-hmm. Okay. Is there an issue out there, too?
We've had every single neighborhood has had issues.
Okay.
We live on the coast, 28 miles of coast, lots of marsh. We have brooks, creeks, and streams coming from the Blue Hills
sure.
all the way down into the bay and the Ponset River. A stormwater drain system that's over 100 years old. Rats are excellent, excellent swimmers. They have a whole subway system under ground where they can pop up and, you know, come up out of the stormwater drains in any neighborhood.
Okay.
And as they multiplied over that real bad winter that
yes.
we had, as they multiply, now they need additional new food sources. They'll start spreading out.
Branching out, yeah.
All they're looking for is, you know, any type of food source, bird feeders, if you put your trash out in
garbage,
trash
right?
bags instead of barrels.
Yeah.
I highly, highly encourage people to use barrels with a lid.
That's simple, huh?
It's that, yeah.
Okay. All right. And, of course, just your dog and cat food.
Yep.
You know, yeah.
Rats will eat dog feces. They'll eat feces.
Oh, interesting.
Absolutely. So you may have a dog, but if you're not cleaning up your yard and you're letting your dog out during the day to keep the rats away, well, when the dog's in at night, the rat's coming in and having...
Oh.
And if the rat sees dog feces or a trash bag of garbage, he's going to pass over the hamburger and go for the steak.
Okay. All right.
So
that's
what happens. And once they've identified a food source...
You're on the list.
You're on the list. You're on their restaurant list.
Yes.
They'll be coming by your house soon.
Hmm. What do you do? Do you fill in a hole if you see one? Or do you
what we
call
do
you,
is or? We bait the area first.
Okay.
Because if you fill it in, then you're not really – they could escape because they always have at least two holes to get out.
Okay.
So we like to bait the area first, and when we bait the area, we usually have the bait box there, and we'll check it in 10 to 12 days to see if there's any activity because it takes the rat a couple of days to get used to it and familiar with it before it will go in and eat the bait.
Okay.
So after that – we'll leave it there until we see no activity at all.
Okay.
And then we'll fill the holes in afterwards because now you know they're gone.
Gotcha. All right.
A little bit of a science to it.
Yeah, it sounds that way. Sounds that way. Have other communities reported the same?
Oh, yeah. I meet, you know, monthly with 28 other health directors over in Canton.
Oh, okay.
Every third Wednesday. We discuss all kinds of topics. Our main purpose is for emergency preparedness activities.
Right.
But we always get the chance to, you know, see what's going on in everybody's area and
right.
what's hot and what's not.
Yeah, well, I mean, Boston's next door.
Boston's
so.
Right next door.
Yeah.
Huge. Boston's actually having a rat summit yesterday, and tomorrow.
Oh.
And I just found out about it yesterday afternoon. Otherwise, I would have definitely have gone in there. But mm-hmm. I have just so many things going on right now, I can't get in there. But
sure.
We've met with an entomologist, actually, who works in for Boston. And he gave us a good education of what we can do going forward with the downtown, how we can work to put preventative measures in so that we can control the issue.
Okay. But in the short term, give your office a call.
Give our office a call. We're more than happy to come out.
Okay. Sounds good. Coming up this spring, Drew, what things we need to know about?
We have the food drive for the letter carriers Saturday. Is it May 10th or is it May 4th?
Hold on. Let me check for you.
Look at the calendar there.
May 14th or the 7th?
It's Saturday, right?
7th or the 14th. Those are both Saturdays.
I think it's the 14th.
Okay.
You'll get a notice in the mail from the U.S. Postal Service.
Okay.
But we're always looking for volunteers down at the Kennedy Center. We'll send a little flyer over so that we can put it on the calendar.
Please, yeah.
Or the,
we'll get that up for you.
The bulletin board?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yep.
I talked with Mark on the way in. We'll make sure we get that over to you.
Very good. Okay.
So, what else?
Mosquito spraying.
Mosquito spraying will start. I'm not sure of the exact date. We've already had the notification. Cindy DeCristofaro, our chief sanitarian, will be putting it on our webpage. I know that they'll be doing some helicopter pellet dropping over the marsh area within the next couple of weeks. We've already sent the notice over to the fire department and the police department and to Brewster Ambulance in case they get any calls, just so everyone knows what's going on. We've already communicated that with them.
Okay.
So what else do we have going on in the wonderful world of health?
Well, there'll be, hopefully soon, beach water testing, although it's far from people's minds when it's 45 degrees outside.
We will start, I believe we start, I don't know, mid-June or something?
Yeah.
We'll do the beach water testing. We're all excited to do that. We'll have the pump-out boat going back in the water.
Oh, very good. Okay.
Within the next month or so.
Mm-hmm.
And we actually have all of our renewals coming up right now, too, for all of our CV, all of our food service licenses. All of our licenses expire in June 30th.
Oh, okay.
My guys will be going out there now to do all the renewals.
Very good.
About 500 of them.
And Memorial Day hours?
Memorial Day hours we're going to talk about on May 10th.
Okay.
It just what the hours are for Memorial Day. They have special designated by the ABCC.
Right. Okay. Very good.
Similar to the Christmas Eve or New Year's Eve hours.
Any concern about Zika here in Quincy, Drew?
Yes. Always have concern. Yeah. In many, many ways, I compare it to West Nile virus, whereas many people will actually get bitten, be infected, and show no signs or symptoms at all. The scary part is they are saying that there's a link between the Zika virus and pregnant women. So that really, really worries me as far as,
people being exposed to that.
Yeah. So hopefully they're coming up and they're working on some type of vaccine, and hopefully Health and Human Services will Congress will fund funds to do things for that.
Yeah,
that's the biggest thing they can do is, you know, fund medical research, right. Congress, in my eyes.
Sure. Yeah, and they've started the process.
Yeah.
It's not entirely 100% what the president asked for, but it's on the radar screen for sure. Yeah.
So.
All right. Always lots going on.
Lots going on. We'll become fast friends now, won't we, Jim?
I hope we are.
We already are, exactly.
Many years ago.
Exactly. Way back like we were doing earlier, right?
Ordering up the number 13.
Yeah. 1300 on the AM dial.
That's right. Drew, thanks for stopping by.
Always a pleasure.
I'll let you get to your morning rat patrol.
And I'll see you May 11th, okay?
All right, sounds good.
There you go.
All right. Thanks again.
Good to see you,
Jim.
You too.